Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Kingsfield Dose. Do-si-do. For those of you guys who are in real time, sorry it's been a little while. My bad. And we're gonna go up to that top left corner there. That is my goal for today. And also all those left sides that I missed that you can see there. So that is what we're going to do. And continue forth with our Kingsfield 2. Ing. Ing, ing, ing. So, see the right and then the second right. Yeah. That's kind of what happens when you just go righty right and then you end up finding an area that, that brings you to an entire new area that's gonna warp you to. So, let's go ahead and go through here and get to those areas that I missed. So, I think it was all the elemental creatures were over here if I remember correctly. That would be my assumption. Okay. Well, time to check some walls, know what I'm saying? Yeah, sorry it's been a little while. It's because I've been working on, a video with Terra Mantis, just working on some lore stuff, and, honestly, it's because my computer was running out of space. Because of all the game capture I was getting for various things that I was working on. So I was just like, man, I just can't record a Let's Play because my computer's just about out of space. So, I got up a lore video that helped clear it up. And on top of that, I got a new external hard drive that's 4 terabytes. So I was like, alright. Oh, well, apparently I should be looking for people before I run into rooms. Wait, what? Oh. Oh, you. Oh, you, circling around me like that. Let me slice you. Let me slice you! The sword is so fast! So something that I forgot to do, that I just completely forgot, that I was reminded about, was see that minus button there, or the select button, not minus button. You can equip magic, and I've just been being really dumb, and I could equip Earth Heal to my magic, to a select button there, and then not need to go into the menu all the time. Just something I totally forgot about, so for any of those of you who were being driven crazy by that, my bad. It's actually something that I always incorporate in Ancient City whenever I play that game. I always do that. I don't know why I forgot to in this one. I think maybe that feature wasn't there in Kingsfield original, so then I moved over to this and just forgot. Yeah, I don't know. I think I'm lying. I think it actually might be in Kingsfield 1 as well. Another one of these things, which is the strangest trap ever. I guess it shoots dark at you, but it doesn't seem to work very well. I thought I was about to get hit just out of spite by that thing for saying that. Where are we going to wrap around to? Ooh. Interesting area. Very interesting area. Maybe not that interesting. Alright, so it looks like I'm gonna have to go around through some sides to get there. What magic do I have? Oh, I have a magic that I thought, yeah, there we go, that destroys faces! Yeah, my bad. That's how long it's been since I played, as I didn't even remember my magic. I think that's Light Flash, which is a light attribute spell. I would worry about my MP that I'm wasting here, but eh, I got Triple Fang. Listen, we pretty much wrapped up, honestly, the big main area of this level. We're done with it, so we're all set. What are you trying to do, huh? Oh man, maybe if I had shot in the middle, I would have gotten both of them. I just thought I'd take care of one of them. Alright, we are cleared up and good to go. Whoa. I was gonna go turn, but this table. But this table! I have to see what's here. Oh, nothing, it's just a table. Just a table. But will there be secret passages? That is the question. A table with secret passages, or is it just gonna be a bone on the ground? Yeah, it's just a bone. Hello, bone. So, alright, something I guess I can talk about while I'm doing all this stuff is some of the Kingsfield 2 lore, or just Kingsfield lore in general. Since we now found out that Seath is evil and he's actually a bad guy, I don't think I'm going to be ruining anything if I talk a little bit more on that. So, when Kingsfield, when the world was first created in Kingsfield... Hold on. Wait a tick. So when the world was first created in Kingsfield, Vlad was the creator of the Earth, I believe. I believe it was Vlad. And Vlad got upset because of all the war going on. And he was like, no, I don't want any war. Just like that. That's nice that I can just do that for this guy. So anyways, really though, he was not pleased that everyone was at war. It was like humans were fighting elves. It was basically a lot of the humans' fault that the humans were just not acting well. And this bothered him greatly. So, that swinging noise, by the way, is actually from the room to my immediate left that we were just in that had the giant pendulums. So what Vlad did was that apparently he couldn't come down to speak to the people. It was against some sort of law or rule. He wasn't able to. So he created two gods to do it instead. The dragon god Seath and the dragon god Guyra. So his hope was that by using these dragon gods, he could steer people in the correct direction. And then that way he wouldn't be directly interfering with mankind and elves and dwarves and all that. But what he didn't foresee was that Seath and Guyra would end up having a giant war against one another, and then all hell would sort of break loose. Great, another Orladin key. So then goes to the Orladin area and the Path of Poison. So Guyra and Seath ended up going to war against each other, and instead it caused even more problems because they were trying to rule and be the one great god. So Kingsfield, the original on PlayStation, most of this really isn't present. There is the Moonlight Sword, but it's really more of a story about Verdite. So that's the original Japanese Kingsfield. Kingsfield 2, or the US Kingsfield 1, is then the story of someone tries to resurrect the dragon guy Guyra, which you, through playing, find out is Necron. And Necron brings back the dragon god Guyra, apparently, and using the power of the Moonlight Sword, which was actually Guyra's sword. That was the all-powerful sword that Verdite had used in the past. And you are going there to stop him. You don't know that Guyra was resurrected at the time when you go there at the start of King's Field. You just know that there's all this evil coming from the land, and it turns out it's all thanks to Guyra and Necron. So, in that game, it's at first you really think Seath is good, like super, super good, a really positive figure. And then there's a twist at the end where it turns out that Seath might not be as good as you think it is, but it's very subtly in there that Seath might not be that great, great god that you think Seath is. Well, there goes another one of my Orladin keys. Damn it! I have six left. I'll be fine. Another half a poison, probably. Stop your poisonous spew, you water demon thing. So anyways, that is Kingsfield 1, is defeating and fighting off Guyra. So, Kingsfield 2 then takes place, and as you guys have been watching, basically, something is wrong. Lyle's father has King Alfred, I believe is his name. King Alfred has for some reason gone nuts and crazy, and no one really knows why, because King Alfred used to be such a great ruler. So now it's being hinted at Seath may have something to do. So that is kind of where we're at in Kingsfield Dose. Kingsfield 2 plot. It's kind of a basic rundown of the plot points, but like I've said before, I am planning on and working on some Kingsfield lore videos. So sorry, it has taken me way longer than it ever should have. It's just I've been sort of mainly focusing on Dark Souls, I guess, which is good and bad, because I do love Kingsfield. But it's cool. I think you guys are going to really enjoy you Kingsfield fans are going to really enjoy the video that Terramantis and I are working on together, which I don't have a specific date when that's going to be done, but it should be sometime this month. That would be my best estimate. Sometime this month. But yeah, I think you guys are going to like it. Sweet, a level up and an Orladin key. This was an amazing happening. From these foul water demon beasts. Yes, I called you foul because you smell bad. Because I don't like the way fish smell. I actually don't like fish in general. Not a fan. I'm not a seafood fan. I love beef and I love chicken, but seafood just does not do it for me. Which I'm sure you guys were really curious about. You really wanted to know my eating habits. Okay, so what I'm going to do, too, is some of you did comment that you wanted to see my dancing. I'll try to find some links that I can link to and put it in this description from various times that I've done, like, breakdancing and just, like, knew who I was. So you can find it. Well, this is the end of this area, so hopefully this will be something cool. And I'll use up my fire keys. Click. What will it be? It'll probably light crystal. Yep. I am so smart. I know everything. Alright, let's use up all of our special crystals. I'm really excited for Kingsfield Ancient City. I can't wait to do that one. I'm just in the mood to play some Ancient City. Which is why a good thing that we're almost done with Kingsfield 2. As much as I enjoy Kingsfield 2, I just love Ancient City. I just love it. So at this point, I could just warp out, because as you can see from my pixie map, I'm done. But let's go ahead and make sure I didn't miss anything. Oops, that's my truth glass. And that's my Leon's note, pixie map. So you see it's all wrapped up there. I've finished exploring this area. So with that said, I could just warp out, but I think I'm going to go back and double check at the cliff area and make sure I didn't miss anything. And then we'll head to the Path of Poison in the next Orladin area. So that would be the timeline here for what I'm going to do. Anyways, I'm trying to decide on a way to do Ancient City, so I kind of do these hour longs, which I think is a good length. If you guys think otherwise, let me know. But the thing with Ancient City is it's such a big game that I'm almost debating maybe I should... I don't know, it almost seems like it'd be more conducive to do. It'll still be an hour long for you guys, but maybe I'll just play 2 hours straight and make that 2 separate episodes. And then that way I could actually get more out quicker to you guys. And on top of that, I think it's just the easier, quicker way to get it done with that particular game. So let me know if you guys mind or don't mind. If you're silent, I'll assume that it's okay. That will be my assumption. So, I'm pretty sure I actually did explore everything here. I think I wanted to double check. Yeah, I really did. Yeah, I did explore everything. It's kind of a hard area to double check and look at because it's so random and weird. But, alright, so with that said, let's go to the Path of Poison. So, I'm going to go ahead and warp over. And yes, I know there's the super rare item that I need to get. I think, according to NMDE, it's the lizard creature, the Garand Lizard, who is in the Dwarf's Cave, drops the super rare drop in this game. I will get that at this point. I don't know if I'm going to do this Let's Play or a next Let's Play yet. I'll see what time it takes me to. It might end up being one in the next episode. Because honestly, like, those drops can take, like, up to 2 hours to get, me just killing one enemy. And I will fast-forward it. If you guys watch my Let's Play Kingsfield 1 videos, I did that with the Spider Sword. So I would be doing the same thing on this, where you can kind of see how long it takes. And I'll try to make it so it's obvious in that sense. Kind of lost my train of thought of what I was trying to find. Now I remember, it's the Icarus Key. Where's the Fairy Fox going to be for? I forgot. I'm gonna do too, just cause, Kassan. We need to go to Ralugo. Not Kissed, Ralugo. Okay, I guess it's here. That's how you can tell it's been a little while. I'm like, wait a second. I saw Ralugo on the map, but it seemed too far south. But I was like, alright, there's that lava bridge that you gotta cross over. So. Other good thing about Ralugo is it's right by the Path of Poison. Anyways, let's go ahead and fill my crystal flask. So let's get everything appraised by the crazy dude. something else I was thinking about with this game. The reason I was thinking about it is because I was looking over some Kingsfield Ancient City translations, and something I didn't realize was that I believe Europe got a different translation than America for the Kingsfield Ancient City specifically. And it was making me think about the translation for this Kingsfield and just kind of how silly a lot of it's been that I've been commenting on. And just wondering how much of it really was true to the Japanese and how much was different. It just really makes you wonder just how accurate are the translations we're getting. It also makes me wish my Japanese was better. I really do want to start taking Japanese classes again, get better, or go to Japan. That'd be wonderful too.
You will be defined by your feet, unless you find the path before the sorrow comes. Orladin was a good example.
Ooh, we can appraise all my Icarus stuff.
This helm is made from the rock which Icarus found near the tree of the Dragon King plant. It will heighten the power of light, increase resistance against specialized attack, and protect against paralysis.
Well, that's pretty amazing. It protects me against paralysis. I already like this armor. Yes. Yes, please protect me against paralysis. This armor is incredible! Okay, it's the same thing.
Evil Ring.
There are two items on Verda with the people attached. We already did that, so we gotta check that one out last time. And just because I'm blanking out right now what the fairy's ring said, the fairy fossil.
Fairies were sent as Guyra's messengers to spy on Orladin. The great Archmage captured them and encased them in stone. They are the connecting point to Guyra, but encased in stone, they are quite useless.
So, if they're a connecting point to Guyra, that sounds as if, while I do think you use Ling's Ring to get the Moonlight Sword complete, the Moonlight Sword is Guyra's sword, so that kind of makes a case for possibly using that to help restore the Moonlight Sword to its glory. Now, Kingsfield 2, I believe there are multiple endings, and I think that depends on if you have the Moonlight Sword or not. So, I'm going to get the Moonlight Sword, period. So, we're going to try to get the best ending, if there are multiple endings. And I am pretty positive that there are. Something also awesome about Kingsfield Symphony of the Night was the alternate ending was an entire new world. Just as big as the original game. In a sense, if it's just the true ending. Ah, it's so good. Such a good game. Probably end up doing a let's play of that down the line. At some point. Right? Melting man-eater plant. Bellflower. Right. That is its confirmation in my mind.
Hello, crazy man. Do you have anything new to say, Joe? There are some slimes here in the passage. You'll need antidote plants, but don't count on their effectiveness too much. You do best have a silver ring. Would you like mine? What do you mean it's a gum wrapper?
There again with the random humor.
I've never been so insulted. I'm a prince, you know. Have some respect. I was going to tell you that if you go through the passage, you'll come to Lake Noel, but now I'm not going to. The lake used to be so beautiful. It was a fitting tribute to the beauty of the queen. You can't cross it now. The bridges over the lake have all been destroyed. Only I can cross it with the special boots. I wonder when Vallada is coming with the key. It was a fitting tribute to the beauty of the queen. You can't cross it now. The bridges over the...
I don't think I've ever gotten that dialogue from him before. It's just something where I kind of just stopped talking to him because I was just running around trying to finish everything. So, yeah, all the characters still apparently, still new dialogues that I'm missing. Alright. Do I want to equip my silver ring? Heck no. I don't want to. I'm just too lazy. Let's just run. Yeah. Part of the reason I didn't is because I was assuming that the Icarus was... Oh, because apparently I already have him equipped. Ha! Alright, I guess I never took him off from when I was in the Orladin area before. That was a huge path of poison. Man, I could have had so much power that whole time if I re-equipped all my green bracelets. Oh well. Seems like I'm doing just fine, and this ended up working out anyways. Right, green slimes? Right. So we are back in the Orladin area here. Now, I could go to the left. I don't think I ever did that. Let me just double check. I don't think I was able to finish those passages to the left yet, because I wasn't. Or I could go to the one to the right, which is going to be a big area. Let's go to the right first, just because we're here. And because I don't want to waste my Orladin keys. I think you can find more Orladin keys in the area to the left here, or right here. With those creepy dragon sounding noises that I'm not afraid of anymore. So, here you go. Couldn't go here before, now I can. Alright. Orladin key. I got 5 left. Do me well. Hopefully this will be enough. So, let's go straight. Just because. I have no real reason to, but let's do it. I think there actually can be secret passages here. Which is upsetting, but not upsetting. Oh god! I thought I didn't get affected by things anymore! Damn you, ghosts! Damn you. Ah, good thing I have blessings. Yeah. How about that? How about that? Ghost. Oh, well, perfect. Another Orladin key. Perfect. And there's a ghost over here. Somewhere. I saw the dark shooting. Ugh. Don't know where, though. Don't know where he is. Might as well check for secret passages. Because I think there actually are some in this area, unlike the other Orladin area, but I could be wrong. This is where I came from, right? Really? It's not? Okay. Okay then. I guess I was wrong. Oh, there's where I came from. That would be why. So, apparently these are not, but I still think there could be. I still think that. Check these walls. Check this. And yeah, I don't know where that ghost was. I thought I saw. I really thought I saw dark magic shooting across, but I guess not. And let's just make sure I wrap up this. And don't miss anything like I did in the land of death and traps. I want to make sure I'm all good this time. Don't want to miss any minor details or minor things. Alright. Well, this area looks special. What could it possibly be? Some armor. Whoa. Whoa! Icarus's armor. It heightens earth power. And now this armor is the Orladin's mail. Orladin made this armor for himself. It will decrease the magical power necessary to cast a spell by 1/2. Holy crap! Alright, let's look at the stats. 96, 95, 96. 96, 95, 96. 96, that's the earliest you remember, actually. 96, 95, 96. 96, 95, 96. 96, 95, 96. So, a lot worse blow and stab defense, but I believe it ups my magic defense. Let's look at all those. So, it's kind of quite the number array there. I equip the Icarus. It is actually a little bit better. Well, Orladin does have the special effect of decreasing my magic spent by 1/2, but that's okay. It doesn't matter too much to me at the moment, because the spells that cost a lot take a long time to recharge. So until I can recharge a little bit faster, it's not gonna affect me either way. Alright, Orladin's key in this, and while I'm doing that, let's shoot the balls. Just in case. Just in case. I have to, it's Kingsfield. It's Kingsfield, it must be done! Alright. Well, this is open now. Well, speak of the devil. That's where they all are. I cannot see him. I'm gonna need to bless myself. Bless you! Thank you, me. Okay. There's another one. Yeah, this isn't too bad now that I can just catch blessing. Not the worst thing in the world. A little frustrating, but not terrible. I've come to know your truth. Though I am to impart the great power, this power is not made available. It must be proclaimed that the one who wakes in the land of the beginning shall... So, this is... Orladin they're talking about. Orladin was waiting in the land of the beginning. Isn't that... yelling... Alright. Anything. Nope. Hello, ghost? You will not! I repeat, you shall not do anything to me! Ah! Crap. Son of a bee. Oh well. This one's not the worst one. I've had worse. Alright. Wall checking time! Let's just do it and get it done with. Walls? Secrets? Walls? I really think there is one here, and that's why I'm doing it. Of course, I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. Alright, let's do this wall side. Nothing! I mean, we do know that this type of wall can have a secret passage, because that's how we even got here in the first place. So, definitely can. But anyways, let's try upstairs. We should do this way. Secrets, come on, man. Alright, well that's good. Well, we got an Orladin key, so that's all good. So these are the things that were making those dragon-sounding noises. They definitely scared me a lot more just by their noise. Their bark was worse than their bite. Let's just say that. Does magic still not hurt me? Nah, I think we need to call my magic stuff again. Light! Flash! Actually, that was probably not very safe when I think about it, because I can die from that. You can die from your own magic in this game. Not the safest thing to do. But, oh well. Alright. Let's put this in the pedestal and move forward. So I'm wondering, really, let's use the fire crystal. Fire magic up. Something I kind of was wondering is, I was looking at the reviews again for Kingsfield the Ancient City, and it was really slammed, and so was this game. I'm just wondering if people tried it again, these games, more like after Dark Souls. Would they enjoy it more, or would they still slam it and think it was terrible? Orladin's pick! I have so many of those now! I do not want them at all! They mean nothing to me! Ah, such a waste of an Orladin key. Oh well. Alright, let's try this first passage, because why not? First passage, we shall try you. As we start running low on our Orladin keys. And there will be no secret passages in this one. At least for now. Hello. Goodbye. Sometimes it feels like I run faster than normal. Like right now, for whatever reason, it feels that way. And I'm not quite sure why. Okay. Like, the speed... I guess the wall... The way the images are flying past make it seem like I'm going faster than I really am. Oh, thank you, Orladin key. I will happily take that. Happily. Ever after. Alright, let's use one of those. Yeah. Another Orladin key area. Alright. Take you out. There's probably one behind me. I think I can hear it. Yeah. Oh, well, that helped. Thank you. I always enjoy that. For helping me fight my enemy, your friend. I appreciate it. Okay, and these guys dropped nothing. So, let's use an Orladin key again. So excited to be using so many Orladin keys. Ah, really? No! Another Orladin key. Jeez. Oh man, I only have one left. Well, hopefully I'll be good. Hopefully that'll be good. Let's see what this one's specials are. Your Orladin Shigarin. Special armor. We have no idea what it does, so I'll have to get that appraised. Huh. Cool. Alright. Probably helps you out with your magic, I would assume. Man. I'm not happy about using so many Orladin keys. I'm just worried that I won't be able to get everything in this area. I could always go buy some, and I'm sure I have way more than enough money to buy all that I need. I was just hoping to wrap this up in one go. The other thing I'm missing is Promius. There is one Promius I'm missing. And I really hope I do find that and not need to kill the guy who I know is holding some. That would be nice. As MMDE has confirmed for me, if you wear all the Promius arm equipment, you do get a bonus to your stats in some sort of way. Which is what I thought, so it has been confirmed. Confirmation. Also, apparently I was completely wrong about passages here. Anyways, let's use my final Orladin key. Sad times. Unless there's a secret passage in here. Never know. Unless you do know, which would mean you've probably played the game before. No! No! I hope there's an Orladin key laying around randomly. Because I really need it to get that treasure. Come on. Come on. Orladin key? Orladin key? Oh, yes! Yes! We have done it! We've gotten all of them in this particular area, not the next area, or the other area that I kind of skipped over. What are you going to be? A light crystal. Let's use it! Alright, light magic up. So, if we look at my map, my pixie map, you can see that I've wrapped up this whole area here. So this is all wrapped up, this is all done, except for that area in the top left, where I need another Orladin key. But I think it's time to go to the graveyard. That is what I'm going to do. And we'll come back here. I have it in mind that we're going to come back here, but I would like to go to the graveyard. So graveyard, I believe, is this one. Let's start making some real progress. Some real, real progress. So, here we are at the graveyard. Maybe I should just have Blessing be my auto. My auto magic for select. Because I'm probably going to be doing a lot of it. Oh man, lost so many tombstones to check. Okay, let's start doing it. And I'm going to try and figure out the best, quickest method to check all these tombstones. So, maybe by row? Yeah, I think row will probably be the quickest way. I think that is our winner. Do it by row. Because honestly, it's very possible that one of these bazillion graves is going to have something. Oh man, alright. I got to think of something to talk about for this whole time. But first, we got to take care of more ghosts. This area with all the ghosts hanging out kind of reminds me of the village that we were in before. However, unlike the village, the ghosts here, well, I guess the village and the ghosts here made sense. Right now, the ghosts totally make sense because this looks like a royal grave, but it has nothing. Ghosts very, very much make sense here because we're at a graveyard, so yeah. Ghosts hanging out by their graves. Yeah, you were not gonna hit me. At least not now. Oh. There he is. There he is. There's another one. I just wiped a bunch of these out, so I don't have to think about them anymore. Yeah, let's just change Blessing to be my auto one. Blessing. Bless you. I can heal up from all this stuff real quick. Whoa. Hello. Let me use my truth glass on you, creepy looking woman. Truth glass. Who are you? You look very creepy. Yvette Bink, Bince, or Bink, Yvette. Alex trapped her fiancé, Sal, in the castle with the king, and of course, she's very angry at him for this. She has a key that you will need, but you'll have to listen to her sob story first. Feign interest. Okay. Once again, with the humor.
Sal hasn't come back from the castle. He was serving there as a member of the king's guard before the darkness came, but then the king changed. Sal was frightened for his life. One day he snuck out of the castle. He had only returned to look for his friend Ent, but now I fear I'll never see him again. He left saying,
"You have no need to worry."
How could Alexander have sealed the whole castle? Didn't he think about the others he would trap in there with only the king's wrath as their reward? I hate him for what he's done to us! If you're going to the castle, I've hidden the key that you may need. Sal asked me to keep it safe, so I hid it in the cemetery. Please rescue Sal. Take good care of yourself.
Okay, so she hid the key we need in the cemetery somewhere. Great. This will be really easy to find. All right, let's get started by going through this cave area first. And through here is a save. So I can save as my reward for the fun times ahead, the hard times ahead. Oh, on another note, what I can talk about is Advanced Wars Dual Strike was in my top 10 list that I'd forgotten. Advanced Wars Dual Strike is the best of the Advanced Wars games, definitely, hands down. I've played that game so many times since it's come out, just like going through trying to beat it. You can beat it over and over and over again, essentially doing New Game Plus with all the characters you've earned and unlocked at the same level they were at, except for there are so many characters and they all level up. See, I just got a moonstone, so again, that kind of makes it so you are notified that yes, every tombstone could possibly have something. Even if it's just a moonstone, which didn't used to be just a moonstone, it was a big deal. Did she disappear on me? Where did she go? Woman, I'm telling you. Yeah, she just went away. Why? That's so random. Like, the Hill of Prayer. Okay. What was that noise? Interesting. Kind of random that she'd just be hanging out there on in a random chair in a random-ass build structure that has who knows what implication. From Software has gotten better about making everything have some sort of meaning. I'm not saying they're bad in this game. They do a lot of times, as I've talked about before, have meaning. But there you go. There's a church bell up there. I wonder if you can ring it, actually. Something. Let me check out right now. Let's find out. Can I ring this bell? No. No, I can't. Eh, I thought it was worth a check. You never know. Alright. Who just did that? Why did you just do that? More importantly. And I got more ghosts to take care of. It would seem as if I have more ghosts to take care of before I can get on my merry way. Come on, you. Let's get this over with. Alright. So I'm going to remember that marked off area there. There's kind of an in-between the graves. But yeah, Advanced Wars Dual Strike is really good because there's tons of different characters you can unlock, and each of them have very different abilities that kind of turn the tide of war in your favor. It is a grid-based strategy game, sort of like Fire Emblem is a grid-based strategy RPG. This is more of a purely strategy game. You already checked these ones. Yeah. So yeah, purely a strategy game for that, but a really good one. Really, really good one. And, I mean, I guess there's RPG elements because you can level your characters, but they don't stay permadead like in the infamous Fire Emblem. That is very infamous for that factor. Very, very much so. Man. So many graves to check. I guess throw is probably the smartest way, but I feel like if I take sides like this, this will do me okay. Alright, so if I remember... Oh, it's probably that big one over there. Anyways, let's check some of these first. Finish up this back area. So many tombstones, so many tombstones to check. Graveyard, it's not fun in a game where everything, that's the gap, where everything could be a secret. In a world where everything can be a secret, you must check every single grave ever. Alright, let's check this stuff over here. And try to, yeah, get this gap done with. Trying to remember that tree was my marker. In my mind, that tree over there. That is my marker for what constitutes as something I've checked or have not checked. So. Oh man, there's no way. I can't even remember. I have no idea what I haven't checked, honestly, at this point. I don't want to be double checking things because that's going to take more time. I don't want to double check. Yeah, I think that's all that. So, let's do this first row. Front row. You have front row seats to the graveyard. Are you excited for that? Up, water crystal. Yeah, again, it just really is worth it to check all these because there's just some good things that you get. The water crystal, like moonstone, not that big of a deal, but water crystal, that's a pretty big deal. That actually is. So, alright, let's check this. Row over here. Something incredibly helpful to make. Like, if you're gonna do a game facts thing for this game, I'd say an incredibly helpful thing for this forest would be, or this graveyard would be, just literally circling, showing all the graves in a map and saying, hey, these are the graves that have something, these are the graves that do not. I bet it's that big tombstone. I mean, it really seems like it is. I'm just trying to check everything, because I'm a good boy. Check it all. Alright. Not you, either. Let's check this side. Crap. Once again, I just really don't know what I've checked and haven't checked. Alright, have I checked this tree one? Maybe not. Alright. I can check them. I think I checked all these over here. Yes, because I did. I was using that tree as my marker. Let's check this row out. That row is fine. Ghosts are coming back. There we go, another moonstone. Hooray! Something that I don't care that much about. Okay, I think that's it. I think that's good. Let's try and find a way to get back there. How do I get back to that area? In the behind. Seems to be kind of cut off. Yes, I will take you out, Ghost. Just because you are asking for it. Just because of that. It's a blessing again. Okay, so how do I get to that grave, I wonder? Probably a secret passage somewhere. Not gonna be through there, not gonna be through there. Did I already get that one? I wonder. I might have already gotten that grave when I wrapped around by the fountain, because I think that's where it took me to. Pretty positive. Maybe I already got her key. I have the... It's just been such a long time. Dwarf, Silviera, Jail, Magician, Silver, Copper, Royal. Could be the... No. Icarus, Lens, Ring. No, I haven't, so I haven't gotten whatever key is. Yeah, this is definitely taking me, wrapping me around to that one grave. So, I guess it's not. Because I definitely already checked this grave. Yvette Vince. Oh, she's dead. Maybe I had to talk to her first. Well, that's kind of creepy. So, I was talking to a ghost the whole time. How wonderful. But we got her key, so hey. Alright. The key of the corridor. Ah, another one I need to check, and I think I forgot to check my armor. Oh well. We shall check the shield later. We need to continue exploring this graveyard, because I keep on going back and forth and saying, like, I'll explore. No, just kidding. I'll explore. No, just kidding. JK. Ja, arimasen. A little Japanese in there. Hey, good stuff. So, alright, well, that kind of wraps up this area. Huh? I have a feeling, yeah. Do not want to go that way. That would be a nice instant death right there. This game has you talking to ghosts all the time. All the time. Always talking to ghosts. Alright, time to properly explore this area. Or once again, at least instead of graves, it's bones on the ground, which there aren't nearly as many. Skeletons, and there's random arrows. Indicating that there is some sort of war over here. Some sort of war. Alright. To make my way over to you as I check the skeletons. Actually, using blessings, kind of a blessing. Ha ha ha. Because... Yeah, there it is. Because I'm going to be leveling up my light magic spells, so I'm going to do it as opposed to Earth, which is what Earth Heal is. So, kind of a good thing, actually. I believe that the blessing is light-based. Got more skeletons to check. Hold on there, Mr. Ghost. I got some bones to check. Unless, are they your bones that I'm checking? Am I pilfering you? I don't know. Maybe. Maybe, and that's why you're so angry. Alright, let's keep on pilfering. I've got some pilfering to do. So this is that other bridge you could cross over. And yeah, I think that's it, so. Alright. Let's go ahead and check out the fountain, which is where I got the Moonlight Sword. It was up here. But might as well go double check, see if I missed anything. Hopefully. Alright. Oh, there we go. I was walking right through. At least these guys aren't casting dark. I mean, yeah, the light spell can be annoying, but at least it's not dark. That's the way I'm gonna look at it. You gotta look at the positives of everything, and that's the positive. Okay, there's a corpse over there that I had never checked, so who knows, that could carry something. I think I kill these guys anyways. Actually, my effect just seemed to disappear for a moment. Must be something I have equipped that helps with that. Alright, I'm tired of this. Tired of this! Madness! Alright. More ghosts! Where are you, ghosts? I will come for you. There you are. I will come for you! What have you got? A moonstone. Tons of moonstones in this area. I guess indicating that they think you probably need your magic when you go inside. Probably. Oh, another ghost. Come on, aren't you tired of this by now? Alright, this is where I got the Moonlight Sword. Nation's future lies in your hands, Alexander Thornton. No, Genesis. Let's try Moon's Ring. Nope. Try the Fairy Fossil. Nope. Alright. Nothing. Where is that Fairy Fossil going again? Seems like something that would have been useful in the path of the beginning. But I didn't see anything, so I guess not. Yes, I get it. There are a lot of ghosts. I get it. I understand. Well, good news is, we're pretty much, I believe we're done exploring this area, so actually we've knocked that out of the way. So let's go ahead and go through here, where this guy's gonna come to life, and I will fight in a giant scythe, where I can stun, which is very good. Alright. Not very freaky there. That was actually a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. I didn't think it'd be easily, like, hard, but I didn't think it'd be that easy. Alright, well, apparently that does nothing. Maybe you have to kill them, if, like, there's some sort of gatekeepers or something, who knows. Alright, green bracelet, yes, green bracelet. I do not need the silver ring anymore for the time being. So, green bracelet we shall do. And we will go through that main gate in just a moment. Green moments away from the big unraveling, the third ever Academy Awards of Verdice. Okay, so there's a dragon stomper here, so that's pretty useful. As in, incredibly useful. Yeah, this triple thing's owns. And look how much quicker I killed that guy, too, thanks to my ring bracelets. It really does make a big difference. I mean, it's plus 10 on strength, because each one's plus 5. So, big, big difference there. Alright, well, with that wrapped up, let's go ahead and save the game, and then I will go inside for the remaining time. And yeah, next episode is probably when I'm going to go ahead and do the secret item. The one that you get as a rare drop. Because, I don't know, I want to go check inside. It's been looming there for so long, we have to do it. We just have to. We must. We simply must. I believe there's actually more to the Orladin set, so I'm kind of curious where I'm missing everything that I'm missing. But, whatever. So this is should be unsealed now, and it is. So here we go. Welcome to King Alfred's Castle. And unfortunately, it seems to be the same music for the time being. I wonder if these walls have secret passageways. Probably not. But I wanted to check anyways. So there should be some courtyard in here too. I'm pretty positive. Pretty positive. Where's my courtyard gonna be? Here we go. Here's my courtyard. Now we are officially inside the castle. At least part of the castle. These guys seem like the type of creatures that would come to life. Actually, they look very similar to what we saw in the intro. Alright, so this is probably where the fountain's going to be, where I can restore the Moonlight Sword. Ah! In fact, this is probably it right here. So let's go ahead and use Lin's Ring. Lin's Ring. Use. Yep. Wait, what? Okay. That didn't do much of anything. Use Lin's Ring. That just heal? Wait a second, where is it? Lin's Ring. Lin's Key. Where is my Lin's Ring? Oh, apparently I threw it in there. Yeah. I don't have it anymore. So, yeah, apparently that's definitely where I was supposed to use Lin's Ring, since I threw it in there. Maybe I need to use the Moonlight Sword? I think Alexander's supposed to appear right now. Use Moonlight Sword. Didn't work. Use Fairy Fossil. Where's my fairy fossil? Nothing. Oh, here's Alexander. Crazy. This is who you played as in Kingsfield 1. I'm very sorry about Lin, but she has done well for herself. It was Lord Varric's wish also that she would be cared for. Did she tell you how she felt about you before she... Yes. Damn it! Yes, she did. Well, enough of that. The techniques of swordsmanship that I shall now teach you will help you in your final hours with he who was formerly your father. Finally, the time has come. Do not regard the one in the castle as your father. Your tomb there was made by those who desire to take your life. The holy sword you carry is not the correct one. You will need the power of the Sword of Light. Guyra will endow the light upon the sword once again. Really? Your subjects are awaiting you. For the sake of your people, you must regain the light for this country. Your true father wishes that as well. Alexander, don't go. Don't go! No! So, let's see what my Moonlight Sword looks like now. Apparently, I need to do more to it. If this even did anything to it. Where is my Moonlight Sword? Wait, did he take it? Oh no, it was a use item, wasn't it? It was in the use item. Moonlight Sword. Still can't. Alexander puts entire being upon the sword to seal the castle. Okay, so I bet that's a fairy fossil thing. So that's what we're gonna have to find out. My swordsmanship just increased. My power is at 100 right now. But I bet if I unequip this and put on silver rings, it would drop by 5. Yeah. I wonder where that affected me. Wish I knew. How it affected me the way it just did. Alright, well, could be through here by the giant seals that make it look important. It's gonna be through the side, though. We have to check. We must do it. Ah, there's another moonstone. Alright, cool. I guess. Cool, I guess. So, the main castle is probably this. Yeah. I mean, this is probably the path to Guyra. A lot of probables there, but I think I could be right. So, here we go. To a save point. And what's up there? No entrance to the Royal Cemetery. What? Buried in the darkness, Prince Austin Lyle Forrester. Ha! Well, there's my grave. Ha ha ha! They are all prepped and prepared for me. Alright, before I wrap up, let's go ahead and see what the Royal Graveyard leads to, because that's where I thought I was. And I shall save my game. And we're gonna wrap up real soon here. Let's just find out what this graveyard entails for us. As soon as it finishes saving. Alright. So, first of all, let's use the truth glass. We are in Verdite Castle, the courtyard of the castle used to be a place of great beauty and tranquility. Alexander, as well as many others, used to walk here in the garden amongst the trees and come to stand by the dragon spring to think. So there you go. There you go. Let's look at the Royal Cemetery. Through these statues that came to life in the beginning. Opening scene. The cinematic. Pretty crazy when you think that, like, every cinematic now is, interesting. Every cinematic from a PlayStation game, normal games nowadays just blow them away. Where shall I be warped to nowadays? Where am I now? This looks like Kingsfield 1. This is Kingsfield 1. The first level of the Royal Cemetery. The cemetery is deteriorated due to a lack of maintenance and has become a nest for evil. The king moved the dragon spring inside the castle walls for protection, and the area is remembered as the nostalgic place of King Alfred. It's funny, though, because they actually made it look very much like Kingsfield 1 in terms of everything. So, yeah, even like the way the rooms look, everything is reminiscent of Kingsfield 1. Pretty cool, really. I totally forgot about this area. But they're definitely doing an homage to Kingsfield 1. It's undeniable. There's no way to say they're not doing it because it's so there. So this seems like it's going to be a big area, doesn't it? Well then. I hear creatures, but I do not see creatures. I hear evil, but I see no evil. Yes, that was a movie reference. The title of the movie that I've actually never seen. I have no idea what they're going to do with secret passages here. That's what makes me feel weird, because I don't want to have to check every single wall. But we shall check some of them. Just for these dead animals. Okay. Well, what do you think? That answers a lot of questions. A leather shield? Wow, that's so crazy. Oh my god. Just what I always wanted. Huh. This area, pretty cool actually. I really like this homage. And yeah, because people have only played Kingsfield 2 and never get it. They would just think that it's just a different looking area. But yeah, this is definitely meant as an homage. So, I'm kind of running late on time here, so I'm probably going to go ahead and save up and come back to this area. But I bet this is what I have to go through to use my... Man, this area is huge, too. I bet this is what I have to go through in order to use my fairy fossil. I have feelings. Strong feelings that is the case. Mummies! The mummies! who are actually a giant pain in the ass in Kingsfield Ancient City. Not nearly so bad. Hello! Hello! Just fall flat on your back. I like it when you do that. I hope I can find a save point in this area. That would be nice. Another dead end that may have a secret passage. I would like very much if I could find some item that just allowed me to run through and not have to check all of them. Useful Ancient City is awesome as they have an item you can equip that does that, although you don't get it until very, very far later in the game, and it's the secret item itself to get. But, yeah. Oh! So, Kingsfield Ancient City, if anyone is curious, is actually a completely different plotline from the Kingsfield PlayStation series. They just completely changed everything. Everything is different, so get ready to complain. Wow. This area is kind of actually bigger than I was expecting. Okay. Now I need to use my PC map to see where I've been. I don't think I checked this area, that was showing that I did. Yeah, because I didn't. What do you know? I was exactly right. Ooh. Treasure chest. That's locked. Looks like a magician's key treasure chest. Yeah, right down to the door from this here. Even that's different. Yes, I will use my verdite at some point. I will use it, I swear. It'll come in handy at some point. I mean, it's just like, you know, right now I even need to find Orladin key. So I don't want to have to waste money when I could use it for Orladin keys. This area is so big! And there's secret passages. Whoa. I'm saying whoa because this is going a lot further than I thought it would. I figured this was just going to kind of be a dead end. They're just throwing every monster at you. This really is meant to be the last place. And a lot of dead ends, too. Alright. Well then. Whoa. Let us go to the left and continue exploring. This giant maze of an area. An earth crystal. Sweet. Sweet, sweet. I like that. I will happily accept your earth crystal. Make my earth magic more powerful. But not learn any new spells, unfortunately. Alright, so that area has been explored. I know there's an area off to the right there, but I didn't check back over here. Where the graves. Okay. Alright. So that seems to be something I missed. It's nice that they're kind of giving you that place so you can see that you missed something. Alright, so I need to go straight ahead. This is this way. So, anyways. Yeah, I just gotta go back down to where I was before. See if I can open that up. Now that I know that there definitely are secret passages. I mean, it could be one along here, but I doubt it. Sure, that is that area I was in before. Oh, thought I heard a noise. That is why I was checking back. Thought I heard a noise there. Alright. So might as well check all these walls. Professional wall checker. I've been leveling up my wall checking skills. It's actually the only thing I've been working on. Alright. Come on. Gotta be a secret passage somewhere around. There it is. There it is! I get it. You wanna kill me, I get it. Wow, you dropped another Night Sword. Hooray. Very much something I've been looking for. Yeah. Yeah, not quite. Alright, well, hey. Making progress. Slowly. One area at a time, but it's happening. Alright, this is probably gonna lead me back through an area that wraps around there, but might as well check it out while we're over here. So, I go to the left through here. That takes me to... This area looks more like Kingsfield 2. Although, I guess there are wooden areas. I think the bases in Kingsville 1 had this look to them. Yeah, like base number 1, base number 2. This is exactly what this looks like. Wow, and there's a merchant. Crazy. Who are you? After Guyra.
After Guyra was defeated by Alexander, he tried to recover in the depths of his tomb. But because of Meryl, your victory over them, the hope of recovery diminished. Guyra's consciousness is filled with hatred against Soup. It exists solely for the hope that Guyra's sword will be restored. Guyra and Meryl who is called back from the dead, are amongst the most loathsome and lowly creatures in existence. I pity them, but even more I pity King Alfred. May his soul soon be put to rest. Why am I not allowed to die? What am I waiting for? Just a little longer, then Guyra's conscience will... Who is this guy? Who are you, man? Let me trick blast you, man. The Skeleton of Light. Controlled by the will of Guyra, he remains undead until his task has been completed. He is the Light family's third generation heir before his death. He still retains the power to bestow light on objects until his soul rests. Okay, so do I give him my broken moonlight sword, maybe? No? Since he has the power to restore light to objects. Nothing for the fairy fossil. Maybe the cute board, or no. It makes it seem like there's something I was supposed to give him, but I have no idea what it could possibly be. Those are really my only two primary items. Unless maybe you find the other piece of the Moonlight Sword and you give him. I'm just not sure. Not sure on him. Alright, well, good that we know he's there. And we're back to more... This blue wall is reminiscent of the Spider Room area in Kingsville 1. It was the eastern area. And I love the music there. It'd be cool if they had, like, some Kingsville 1 music make a return. I would have really enjoyed that, because I actually really like the Kingsville 1 soundtrack. Some people like this one more. Actually, I prefer the Kingsville 1 soundtrack. I think that's my favorite soundtrack of the entire Kingsfield franchise is from the first game. The first US game, specifically. So I do need to note that. It's actually an important point. Well, I guess good thing we checked over there. It all worked out. So I believe that we should actually walk up to the Larry on the left. I think this is probably where I came from. Let's use my pixie map, but I think this is where I had explored first. Yes, because it is. That would be why. And we got more mummies to deal with. Heyo! Mummy. That's okay. He walks over. Stumbling across, I'm fine with that. Just totally fine. This area is so big! Alright. To the right here. What is this away? Yeah, I have no idea which is the right way, which is the wrong way, anything. I really have no clue. Oh, wait. Well, whatever. Shouldn't be. Oh, some new enemies. What are you? New enemy? That's a true classic. You are? Living statue. The stone statue which was given life through a spell. It makes an excellent guard for he simply stands as a stone until an invader appears. He's high on defense and low on offense. So, okay, well, that's kind of nice. Not much offense gonna come from this dude. And yeah, not much. I think the place at the beginning is probably supposed to be one of the hardest areas. Probably. Like, after doing that, I've just reached enough levels that all this kind of doesn't matter so much. Alright, let's check this room for secret passages. Because it's so random. I'm really hoping to find a save point, but there just may not be one in here. I'm just so intrigued by this area. I just wanted to explore it. Graveyards. Your graves. Do you have anything? Probably not. Alright. Well, that is that area explored. Actually, a little bit more involved than I thought of, to be honest. Let's try this side now. Seems like it's just gonna be more of these guys. Oh,
I should have waited to kill him. Let his buddy hit him first. I messed up. I made a boo-boo. Alright. Nothing there. So, what about through this way? It's amazing because I still haven't won. I should just be doing my righty-right-right-right path. Oh, hello. You're wearing... Ah, my god. That was not smart. That's Cease gear from Kingsfield 1. Actually, that's what he's wearing. Kingsfield 1 Cease set, which was the most powerful set in Kingsfield 1. So, there's some backstory for you guys on that. Meryl Ur. Oh, it's Meryl Ur. He used to be admired by many elves because of his devotion to Seek and his superior fighting skills. He's now dreaded as he came back as an undead. Huh, undead? Demon Souls? Dark Souls? Dark Souls? Not Demon Souls, Dark Souls. He wanders around mournfully seeking Guyra's will in the cemetery. Okay, buddy. Look, I just cast like a crazy magic spell on you. I kind of feel bad killing you, to be perfectly honest, but it doesn't seem like I have much of a choice. Yeah, he is not that hard. Not, it's pretty easy to circle around. Thought you'd be easier, man. I mean, harder. Oh, sweet, we got Sea Sword. That's pretty awesome. Sea Sword from Kingsfield 1. The Sword of Meryl Ur, Hero of the High Elves. The sword has the sharpest blade of all the weapons. It was presented to Ur by Sea. Sweet. Alright, let's see which one's better. Alright, so, status. 128, 76, 98. 28, 76, 98. So this one has better slash, but it has no holy damage. And everything else is far worse. So let's, show what it looks like. And, oh, this appeared. Maybe this will take me to Guyra? That would make sense, they'd be guarding Guyra. Oh god. Hello, giant version. This area is pretty insane. Ah, something hit me that is not good. What are you? Truth Glass. Death Fighter. Death Fighters are the armor of the soldiers killed by Black Knights. They are controlled by Seath and have risen to fight again, remembering the hatred they died with. They are quick and will not cease fighting unless destroyed. Alright, let's put the triple thing again. I think it's a better sword. I'm pretty sure. It's kind of a secret they get, so it makes sense that it would be better. This area reminds me a little bit of one of the areas in Chrono Trigger where there's a lot of warp points for you to step on. Because it would seem like that is what they're doing. Alright, well. Oh, maybe for killing each one of the warp points to choose. Maybe, probably not. Nah, it's not. Alright, well, this area was not that bad. Wonder what's gonna show on my pixie map though. Let me see my pixie map. But I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, this is just kind of an area of its own. Where's this gonna take me to? More of this stuff. Yeah, you know what? This is the demons from Kingsfield 1. So these guys are Demon Lord. He's an evil creature created mainly by Guyra. There are several variations. This type is the final perfected version. Holy crap! Holy crap! Wow. I'm nothing against that area. I just feel like I should go back to the beginning and check it out. Wow, this area seems to be more intense. Oh, this is a war point that you get to. I guess. Can I warp back? Yes, I can. Well, that's good. We will come back to this. Oh man, I'm so far over what I wanted to do. I'm just like, this area is interesting to me. I have to keep going. Although what I really need to do is go save my game. Nice if there was a save point, just saying. Just throwing that out. Maybe someone's listening. Unless they don't want you to get trapped here. Where it's supposed to be like the final area, so you can't save. Make it harder. Which is very possible. Okay, nothing there. So let's look at our pixel map and remember where that area is so I can come back to it. Alright, it is that. Oh, it's the top of the map, so that helps. The top of the map is going to be where I need to get to, back to. What is this way? Kind of the very obvious secret wall. A broken sword. And that would seem to be it. Yep, that is it. Just a broken sword. Fine by me, because we are so far over. Let's wrap this biatch up. I don't need to kill these guys. It's fine. I already killed you guys. It's fine. There's gotta be a save point somewhere around here. There's just gotta be. Oh, speaking of a royal cemetery. Watermelon heads! I love them! Yay! Check this one. Let's do this thing. Seriously, where is the save point? Tombstones, all around. Tombstone pizzas, all over this place. Alright, I was hoping this would be the one that would wrap up to a tombstone, but I guess not. Instead, it wraps up to a moon. Strength of, sweet. And a moonstone. And probably a dead end. Yeah, dead end. Oh, there's a blood ruby. Bloodstone. I always call them blood rubies. Because of Dragon Ball Z, Curse of the Blood Ruby. That really is probably why. It's part of my upbringing. Alright. You shall go away. Because that's it. And this is another big area. Come on, I don't got no time for you guys. I don't got no time. This area is so giant. Wow, man. Wow. I saw Bloodstone down there. Yeah, there it is. Bloodstone, got it. No, you couldn't see it. I was just that quick to the draw. Alright, anything over here? Nope. And these walls are too small. I don't think there's any secret passages in them. Pixie map! Slowly but surely wrapping this area up, even though I didn't mean to. It was all a mistake. It was not meant to be. Okay. Fine by me. So we must keep on going. And sometimes when you hear skeletons and stuff, even though I didn't do it last time, I really just indicated that, hey, there's more to this area. Which area do I need to go to now? I need to go straight ahead. Alright. Straight ahead we shall go. To more big area. Oh, I missed it. Whoops. Whatever. Alright. I'm gonna go all the way over across and go to the right. And if there's nothing there, I'm just gonna go ahead and warp out and save it. Wrap this thing up. So, take care of these mummies. And more. I figured this area would still be big. Like this part of this level. So, well, hopefully this guy will have something useful. Nope, he is just dead. And he apparently died for no reason. There is really nothing here. Well, sir, you passed out for no reason. I don't know why, but I'm sorry. Sorry to hear it. Alright, and so. Nothing. No thing. And yeah, nothing over here. Some dead ends. I was kind of hoping there'd be a save point in here, but it doesn't seem like. Oh, here we go. Hey, I found it. Alright, sweet. That is some good news. Just finished checking this area out, and we should save and wrap it up. I don't care about your dual tomahawks. Alright, so that wraps up this area. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I'm sorry once again about the length of this episode. This game is just really big. It's really big. I mean, you can tell I've done longer episodes this time than in Kingsfield 1. And this is, I believe, the 17th Let's Play. Kingsfield 1 only made it to 16 with shorter episodes, so definitely a much bigger game for Kingsfield 2. But again, thank you guys so much for joining me, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.